Microsoft announces the release date and pricing for the Xbox One, a new Xbox 360 console, and finally a look at a ton of new games. Hey everyone, I'm Maida Lashani, filling in for Andrea Renee. We'll have more from E3 in the days to come. Microsoft kicked off the party with their press conference this morning, announcing a whole bunch of titles for the Xbox One, many of them exclusive, along with the release date and price for the new console. Xbox One will be available this November for $499. After some backlash from their unveiling a few weeks ago, it's no surprise Microsoft was quick to state that it's all about the games, and to their credit, we did see a lot of them. Metal Gear Solid V, The Phantom Pain, started things by channeling a little Red Dead Redemption with Snake riding horseback across the countryside. Then Microsoft kicked things back to the 360, unveiling a new version of the system along with three titles coming to the console: World of Tanks, Max, The Curse of Brotherhood, and Dark Souls 2. After that, it was all about the Xbox One. Crytek will be bringing us Rise, Son of Rome, a QuickTime Event heavy action title focusing on combat and command. Rare is bringing back Killer Instinct after 7 years on hiatus, and Insomniac is working on a quirky title called Sunset Overdrive. Forza Motorsports 5, which we saw a few weeks ago, was shown in greater detail, including a new Drivatar, a system that learns how you drive in-game and uses that to customize how other cars are behaving, making the AI feel more human. Quantum Break was another title we saw more of, a blending of gameplay and television show, and today we found out that your choices in-game will affect the outcome of the show. We also found out about the world builder, Project Spark, which looks to be trying to channel the community creative experience of games like Little Big Planet, letting you quickly generate terrain and upload AI brains into objects. Capcom showed off Dead Rising 3, now with a larger open world, and Battlefield 4 demonstrated a new gameplay running at 60 frames per second. Or tried to, anyway. Talk about a bad time for technical difficulties. We also saw the Xbox One edition of Minecraft, D4, Crimson Dragon, The Witcher 3, Wild Hunt, Halo, and of course, the Halo from 343 Studios. The conference ended with the official unveiling of Titanfall, which looked kind of like a love child between Call of Duty and Hawken. What did you guys think of all the games shown off? What are you most interested in, and more importantly, is it enough to make you buy an Xbox One? Personally, I can't wait to get my hands on the new Killer Instinct. Full gore rocks. I'm Maida Lashani, and be sure to keep checking back with us for more E3 coverage throughout the week.